Welcome back to Art Matsker. I'm Matt. This week I draw the next car from Mad Max. I've been pretty obsessed with drawing cars lately. Found a new love, I suppose. I'm not really a gearhead particularly, so trying to find a lot of reference for parts of the machine, like the engine. I don't know what some of that stuff is, so I'm having to dig through lots of photos and different videos. And for this particular scene that I'm drawing, the car is basically doing a 180 spin around like it happens in the movie. But the reference I used was not actually from the movie itself. The character on the back is actually on top of the engine because of something that happens in the movie, la 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 la. But the reference I found was actually from some behind the scenes videos from when they were testing the automobile, and it didn't have any of the fun parts on it. It didn't have the exhaust pipes or anything else. And I basically used that as a reference, a freeze frame from a video, and did a bunch of research trying to basically rebuild the car from, you know, different photos and different things. And when I started this drawing, I didn't really have a plan of how it was going to look. Like, originally I was kind of drawing it to be like the typical comic book character style, but as I progressed with it, I felt it was better to go for, I don't know, I'm not going to say realistic, but, you know, more painterly quality about it. Just fit more with the subject matter than, I guess, drawing it like my typical comic book stuff. So as you see, as I go through this whole thing, I try to eliminate the hard lines as much as possible, or make them blend in better so there's no hard black lines. I don't try to get rid of the lines completely or anything. There's a graphical quality to them that really speak to me, and I like it in my artwork, so I'm going to continue to use them for the time being. One day, maybe, I'll try to do a fully painted something or another without any kind of a pen and ink work in it, but the cards are kind of complicated, and it's easier to just use the line, so I'm going to do that. I was kind of having a hell of a time getting Nux to fit right inside of the vehicle. They're just, you know, size. How big is a human being in comparison to this thing without, you know, actually being next to it, sort of thing. So, you know, I think it looks okay in there right now. He's decent size. The vehicle itself is not exact proportion of how it would be in real life. I mean, it's kind of distorted in certain ways because, you know, from different angles you get certain different views on it, and I kind of mix them all together for more of a feeling than an exact replica of the car. The layer size was like something like 25, 26 layers on this whole thing. You know, it comes down to, you know, adding smoke on top of things, keeping certain things separate so I could change them later without destroying certain other things. You know, the windshield is on, inks are on a separate layer than the stuff in the background because I was trying to help create a volume inside the vehicle. So to have them separate colors, I had them on different layers, and, you know, it becomes difficult to manage, but, you know, you pay attention, you figure it out. And that was my drawing. I hope you like it. Thanks a lot. Bye.